write down LC oscillation. See, till now every chapter, sorry, every circuit we had resistance R somewhere sitting. Okay, first time in this circuit we don't have resistance, only L and C are there. Okay, and we are talking about a special kind of scenario here. There is no battery. Fine. What has happened here is that we have charged the capacitor with a battery. So capacitor has some charge now. Okay, now we are discharging the capacitor against the inductor. So basically this is a circuit. Draw the circuit first. This is inductor, this is capacitor. Okay, so capacitor already has a charge of Q0 at t equal to 0. Fine. And when it has charge Q0, you have kept the switch open. And after some time, you have closed the switch. Alright. And now we are analyzing what is happening. Can you try to see what is happening? I mean, just write down the Kirchhoff's loop equation for this loop. First do that and let me know. Assume at any time t, charge in the capacitor is Q. And write the circuit equation. If charge at any moment on the capacitor is Q, potential drop across capacitance will be Q by C. So it will be Q by C, potential difference across capacitance, and across inductor what will be the potential difference? L di by dt. So Q by C minus of L di by dt equals to 0. Okay, how many variables this differential equation has? 3, Q, I and T. Fine, in order to solve it, I need to reduce it to 2 variables. How can I do it? Can I say I is equal to dq by dt? What is Q?
So it's dq by dt.
What is Q? Q, what is
C?
What is Q? I'm asking what is this Q? Where it is?
Charge
where?
In the capacitor.
This is not the charge that is flowing.
Yeah. Okay, so that's a different Q.
That's a different Q.
Which way would it be?
Hold on. I is not charge, first of all. I is what? Rate of flow of charge. Fine. Rate of flow of charge on this wire is I. Okay, will that be equal to rate of charge that is going away from this capacitor? It should be right. But then if you say that Q is the variable you're taking, not what charge is flowing here, then if Q decreases, current will increase. So I is not dq by dt, I is minus dq by dt. Because dq is a negative quantity. Charge in the capacitor when decreases, dq is negative. Okay? So I is minus of dq by dt. Fine. So when I substitute it here, I'll get d square I by dt square, sorry, d I by dt
so
is equal
d, d cube by dt square.
D square q by dt.
Yeah, d2
q by
d2.
C sir is writing.
It is d square q by dt square. So basically q by c plus l of d square q by dt square is equal to 0. So I get what d square q by dt square is equal to minus of 1 by lc times q. Now does this remind you something? What does it remind?
So it's like that.
No, you said something.
Yes, like Q by capacitance.
No, not that. From some other chapter, does it remind you something? Ajay, tell me, how will you solve this? This is second order differential equation. Have you seen second order differential equation in physics before? What is acceleration? Dv by dt. And what is v? Dx by dt. So a become d square x by dt square.
Yeah.
Have you seen any relation between d square x by dt square and x?
So we did it when we were doing the series on analytical solution.
Are, I'm saying beyond this chapter.
Oh yeah. There's only one. Huh?
Have you seen this equation d square x by dt square? Have you seen this? This is acceleration d square x by dt square. Acceleration is equal to minus omega square x. Have you seen this before? What it is? It is SHM equation. Okay? So the solution of this is in this form, x equal to a sine of omega t plus phi, where a and phi depends on initially what is the condition. Getting it? Fine. Now this equation looks very similar to that. Fine. So mathematics doesn't care whether it is charge or x. If this is the solution for this differential equation, for this differential equation, what should be the solution?
Q
is equal to maximum, sorry, q naught, let's say q naught it is, sine of what? Omega
gaya.
1 by root LC times t plus phi. Or we can say, you know, q naught, this is q max, because this is its maximum value. Like amplitude is the maximum amplitude in SHM, sorry, maximum displacement from the mean position. Similarly, qm is the maximum possible value. Okay, now initially what is given here at t equal to 0, the charge is q naught. Fine. So when you put t is equal to 0 here, you should get q naught. So this is q naught is equal to maximum value of charge into sine of phi.
So it's q
naught
here?
What is q
naught?
Okay. Now, charge cannot be created. Are you getting it? Charge cannot be created. So on capacitor at any point in time, charge cannot go beyond what was initially q naught. Fine. So if Q naught is should be the charge at t equal to 0, which should be its maximum value, then what will be the value of phi? 90 degree, pi by 2. Fine. So value of phi is pi by 2 as at t equal to 0, Q should be maximum. So QM is what? QM is Q naught and phi is pi by 2. So we got the solution of this differential equation as Q is equal to Q naught sine of omega t plus pi by 2. What is sine of omega t plus pi by 2? Cos omega t. So this is Q naught cos of omega t Q. Now, can you plot a graph between charge and the time? This is time and this is charge Q. Charge on the capacitor. This is the charge on capacitor. Can you plot the graph? By the way, this omega is 1 by root LC. Okay, so you will get a graph like this, isn't it? A cosine graph you will get. Okay, so you can see that charge on the capacitor positive. The total charge in the capacitor is 0 actually, you know, that positive plate and negative plate. But if I look at just one plate, what is the charge on the one plate? It is positive initially, then it goes to 0, then negative, then again become positive. Fine. So the charge on the capacitor is fluctuating. Fine. Now Q is this. What about current? How much is the current? Value of current, how will you find? I is what? Minus dq by dt. I is minus dq by dt. So if you do that, you will get what? Q naught omega sine omega t current. Okay, is the charge stored in a capacitor? What is the formula for that? That is charge, energy stored. Energy inside the capacitor is what? Q square by 2C or half CV square, whatever you may want to write, right? So at any moment, energy on the capacitor will be Q square by 2C. And at any moment, what is the energy stored in the inductor? How much it is? Half into Li square. We have done this in moving charge and magnetism. Okay? This is energy in the inductor. This is energy in the capacitor. Fine. Now, tell me, is there any energy loss happening? Suppose initial energy in the capacitor was Q naught square by 2C. Is the energy getting lost somewhere, or it is just coming back and forth, you know, it's oscillating? What it is?
Lost.
It is going back and forth, right? Energy is not getting lost. What is happening is that this electrical energy converts into magnetic energy, and this magnetic energy again then converts into electrical energy. So there is a fluctuation going on between electrical energy and magnetic energy. Fine. Now whatever is a fluctuation, the sum of this energy plus that energy should be a constant.
Yeah.
Should not depend on time. Prove it. prove that this plus that is a constant. Everything is written. Mohan.
What exactly are we supposed to prove that?
It is independent of time.
The total potential.
Total energy.
Total energy.
UC is depending on time or not. When you do Q square by 2C, it depends on time. Cos square omega t will come. But when you add it up with half Li square, it should be independent of time. UC is Q naught square cos square omega t divided by 2C. This all of you got? Okay. UL is what? Half Li square. So this is half L into, this is I, Q naught square omega square sine square omega t. If I add this up, will omega t will go? It doesn't seem like, okay? But if you pay attention, omega is what? 1 by root LC. This will tell you omega square is 1 by L into C. This, if you substitute here, you will get UL equal to Q naught square by 2C sine square omega t. Getting it? Now if I add this and that, what will I get?
Zero.
Zero?
No, sorry. Total.
We'll get U Q naught square by 2C sine square omega t plus cos square omega t. What is sine square plus cos square? 1. Okay? So this disappears. Whatever is the time, sine square plus cos square will be always equal to 1. So this will be equal to Q naught square by 2C. So the total energy is independent of time. This is what we have derived in idealistic scenario. Any doubt? But this is impractical. This doesn't happen in reality. Why? Because the inductor will have some resistance. Write down. Energy may not get conserved in LC oscillation due to following reasons. The first one is the inductor will have some negligible resistance. Okay? Which we are ignoring, so you know, energy can get lost from that resistance. That is point number one. In point number two, even if suppose inductor has zero resistance, then also this inductor will have magnetic field lines, and while it is oscillating, magnetic field getting converted to electric field over here, the magnetic field lines could get lost. This can emit radiation, the inductor. Fine? So then there will be radiation loss, even if it is ideal inductor. Right? So slowly and slowly energy will decrease and will just die down. So this is LC oscillation. First time we have studied a circuit in which there is no resistance. In fact, if you see, there is no voltage supply also. Okay?